It's about keeping it simple. If you've got a great idea for a show, you need to refine that idea to its simplest base elements to be able to communicate it. Because if it can't be made that simple, it can't be made.
Your one pager is your front door. It's your menu, if you like. So your one pager is your idea, it's your title, it's your log line. That's the one that's got me on the hook.
The idea of the pitch document is it is you when you are not in the room. Now, it'd be lovely if you could go into Channel 9 or the ABC or Channel 10 or Channel 7 or Netflix and sit there forever. But it's not going to happen, is it? They're going to ask you to leave at some point. So you leave them a document. That document is you when you are not in the room.
The first thing is simplicity of an idea, really drilling down into a core concept that's clear and can be really explained in one sentence. It can be built out after that, but it needs to really resonate just with one core sentence. And when it comes down to that one line, does it make you laugh? Does it make you surprised? Does it make you want to watch?
I honestly think a one-page pitch document is the hardest document you'll ever create on the journey of your show, because most unscripted formats are the sum of many parts, as in it's not one line, it's many things rolled in to make a brand or a product. You would need to sell, okay, my title is this, the log line is this, the host is this person probably or someone like that, and it's going to appeal to this kind of audience, and here's the basic sort of format structure.
Don't bury your lead. What is the show? Straight off the top. If you can't say it in the headline, say it in the first sentence afterwards. I've seen a lot of pitches, they come through and they give you a whole lot of background before they get to what the show is. Don't do that. Just right off the top, what's your show?
After the title, I reckon log lines are probably the most important part of your deck, because they're going to sum up in one sentence what the show's about, but also how you're going to sell that show and how the audience is going to hear that show.
I think when you're creating that one-page pitch deck, you want to really succinctly summarise your concept in the first line or two. Make sure the reader isn't trying to figure it out as they're going through. So that idea has to really resonate. But then you might want to have a statistic or an article or something that really backs up, you know, why you want to tell this story, why you want to create this format.
So you've got the title, you've got the one-liner, you've got a great visual, paragraph. The paragraph has to hook me in, has to tell me what it is, why it needs to exist, why now, why it's different, why you're a safe pair of hands. Who's the audience? Why are they going to watch it? That paragraph does some very, 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 very heavy lifting.
Go in with a very simple paragraph, and if pitched the paragraph, you'll get a very quick answer, yes or no. We like that idea, we have that idea, we don't have that idea, give us more.
If it's an original production, that's its selling point. It's original because why? Why is someone going to tune into that? You need to be able to sell it on its strength. If it's unlike anything else on television at the moment, that's your calling card. That would be my opening statement.
The big challenge, I suppose, is we're so far into the television journey that the likelihood of coming up with something new, that's the big challenge. So no one's ever seen this before. Like, there's been so much TV made in the last decades that if you can find something new and interesting, then make the pitch sound great, by the way. That's it. You've got to get it across that first line. I think that's the big challenge, finding something really unique and interesting that no one's ever seen before, and you can get the wow factor at the pitch.
Have a think about who is going to watch it. Who is your audience? Why are they going to watch it?
Know the market. Know the person you're selling to. Know what type of shows that they've got. Work out where this show could sit. What show would be on before it? What show would be on after it? Will it meet the demo that they're after? Just a bit of it's simple research like that is understanding the market first and foremost, so you can speak to that when you're in there.
And don't pitch the same idea to multiple networks and think you'll get away with that, because every network's completely different, you know, bespoke the idea to the network.
Yeah.
Very specifically, and it's really common that people do that. They have that one great idea, they can't let it go, so they pitch it everywhere, and then they just gets lost, and they've lost it. Just wait, sit on it, come up with a new idea.
Be super confident. Believe in what you've created. Don't apologise for an idea. Don't try to overthink what a judge or a broadcaster may want. What they want are successful shows. People want hits. It's really simple. Your show, you need to think about it being a hit, and don't recoil from that.
So you have a good idea and you've tested it. You've talked to people about it. You've made sure that it's different. It has a market. It has an audience. It's a really simple format. You can describe it in a sentence. It needs to be made now. You're a safe pair of hands. You need to have a pitch document. The idea of the pitch document is it is you when you are not in the room.
In a one-page pitch document, you want to be able to read it and feel like this is possible to make. You don't want to read it and go, oh, this is going to be too expensive or it's going to be too hard. So what are the details you need to include to make it easy? That's what I would include. So if it feels like it's going to need a really important key talent to make the show happen, we'll get that key talent on board before you pitch the document, you know, before you pitch the idea, and have that included on the document. So it's like, wow, this show's going to be really hard. Oh, wow, you've got the hardest person to get. Beautiful. So you don't want to look at this thing and go, this is going to be too hard to make, impossible to make. You want it to be excited by it. You want to get it. You want that person to pick up the phone and give you a call and go, hey, come and talk to me about this. This thing sounds shit hot.